Freaks, it's Monday, April 17th, 2023. Coming up on the program today, how to have sex like a mad scientist's assistant in a 1950s horror film. Okay. Plus, I've got some exciting news. I think I'm a Muslim now. Masturbating to get that pain out of your ass. And shout out to all you shower shitters.
It takes will to take a two-year-old baby and to take them and put them in a chamber and send high radiation through them until they die. Or to give them a lower dose and watch them die over 2 weeks. I mean, it takes will to go fry a little baby and then watch them bleed out and watch their fast-growing cells die and their intestines melt in them and their teeth all fall out and blisters all over their faces. It takes a lot of will to do that, and I want you to know that's the type of demon creatures that are just an inch away from you and your family. Taking toddlers, putting them in a radiation tank, and frying them? Oh, but they wouldn't, and that's admitted. I mean, you know, frying babies, folks. But you want to load jets up full of children, some of which are going to have their heads blown off after they're raped.
Baby, baby, baby. Oh. Baby, baby, baby.
Yo!
Baby, baby, baby.
Ah! They torture children with pliers sexually. They like it that children are getting their arms and legs blown off with landmines. The best way to describe the New World Order is a pile of dead children with maggots eating them. By the way, it's coming out about Nixon wanting to abort black babies. I have an audio clip I'm not sure I even want to play. It's a high-level Bush administration official saying that they can torture small children and crush their genitalia. You know, I said I wasn't joking when I said they'd probably be barbecuing small children on the White House lawn or maybe cutting the tops of their heads off and eating their brains with a dull spoon and calling it love of the Lord. They're already putting clone human embryos, human babies, in cow uteruses. People don't stick babies in microwaves. Dead children rotting with lime all over them. Dead babies covered with worms. That's what they like, is demons eating babies. Child raping demons. Children can be loaded into catapults and used for skeet practice. Hurting children makes me mad. This president has legal power to torture children. The government's gone, folks. We're in crisis level. Gone.
They like blowing children's heads off with handguns. Okay?
Gone. The country's gone. 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 That's what I said. It's just gone. I told them, your children have no future. And one of them had a little tear in his eye.
The Distorted View Show with Tim Henson.
Christian now fears his flatulence.
A lot of hot liquid poo just went out all at once.
Welcome to 1-800-ASSHOLE.
The vagina is full of AIDS.
All right. Hey, freaks, Tim back here with you to kick off a new week of programs. Got a great show for you today. As I was looking for content for you, I ran across one of those websites that link to a bunch of other articles. You know what I'm talking about? Like, typically at the end of an article, there's like this grid of images and headlines from other sources. Half of them are advertisements. They all have to be extremely eye-catching because they can't just bombard you with pop-up ads anymore like they could 10 or 15 years ago. We all have ad blockers installed. So now they're just trying to confuse you into clicking a link. And by that, I mean, you see the headline and you see the picture and you're like, what? They want me to mix Vaseline and toothpaste together for what? And I had to click on it. That's exactly what this link was leading to. An article about how you should be brushing your teeth with Vaseline and toothpaste. It appears to be an advertisement, and they pull no punches. They're very frank. Do you have yellow rotting teeth? Don't we all? Like, if you have yellow rotting teeth, Vaseline's not going to help you. You need to go to a dentist. Rotting. Do you have rotting teeth? Are they all black and falling off and stink? What you need is some grease to make them real shiny. Oh, they'll still be black, but it'll be a glossy black. A nice rotting shimmer to it. Like, what the fuck are these people talking about? The article reads, and this is a total advertisement, 60-second ritual rebuilds your teeth and gums. Finally, a solution to yellow rotting teeth. Sewage breath. Oh my God. Sewage breath and bleeding gums may become a thing of the past. Simply let this soft mineral candy melt in your mouth to give the good bacteria enough time to address and fight years of tooth damage. It's weird because they tell you to watch a video and in the thumbnail, there's, you know, the Vaseline and the toothpaste, but you click on the video link and it just takes you to a website And they never mentioned the Vaseline again. They want you to buy these fucking drops for your teeth or something. Oh, it's so fucking scammy. You got me. You got me to click. I did a quick Google search for mixed Vaseline and toothpaste to see if anyone else was doing this. And apparently people will mix it, not for their teeth, but they'll apply it to get rid of pimples and stuff. Like a skincare regimen. Not going to help you with sewer mouth, nor rebuild your rotting teeth. All right, listen, enough of this. Let's get into some audio. This first clip was submitted probably about 15 years ago, and I'm just getting around to playing it now. So I'm sorry, whoever sent this in, Corey, maybe? Electro Baby? The one they call the Enigma?
This is the one they call the Phenomenal Enigma.
The Phenomenal Enigma. It might have been a Sideshow exclusive program, but recently I found the first batch of voicemails to ever come in to the 206-666-4463 number back in, I don't know, 2005 or 2006. I just happened to have them on an old hard drive, so I was replaying some of them for you freaks. And this guy is my favorite listener of all time. The Enigma, the Phenomenal Enigma.
Phenomenal Enigma, yeah. Otherwise known as the Scorpion.
Oh, that's right. He was unhappy with the name Scorpion, so he gave himself an upgrade. Those are the fucking dopes calling into the voicemail line back in 2005. Now we've got Twink Toilet. Not much has changed, right? Anyway, the clip I have for you today that was submitted by someone listening to this program ages ago is an audio instruction track, I guess, to help newly out-of-the-closet homosexuals feel comfortable having sex. So, you know, it's basically just audio porn, I think.
Welcome. This is going to be an interesting experience for both of us.
Doesn't he kind of sound like Riff Raff from the Rocky Horror Picture Show? You know who I'm talking about? Like, time is fleeting. Madness takes control.
Welcome. This is going to be an interesting experience for both of us.
Master will be right in to drain your balls. It's like Igor. Yes.
You'll need to be somewhere where you can listen to this audio in privacy.
Maybe the laboratory.
Undisturbed.
Yeah.
Ideally somewhere where you normally feel very relaxed, safe, and comfortable.
Like your mother's gravesite. I'm going to fast forward a bit here because it's almost like a hypnosis. He's like, find a quiet place and close your eyes and count with me. I'm not sure what he's trying to do here. Is this hypnosis? The person purchased this audio tape. You don't have to try to coax them to do gay shit. They're ready, willing, and able.
And then my fingers lift your chin, and you look into my face, and I kiss you.
This sounds like I'm making out with my grandfather, you know? If I purchase this audio tape, gay instructions, I would hope I'm paying to hear like a hunky sounding guy. Someone I'd wanna fuck. Not whatever the hell is happening here. We begin to make out. My dry, chapped lips on yours as reruns of Bonanza play in the background on my old ass television.
My lips firm on yours. Parting your lips so that my tongue can enter you. Taste you. Find your tongue and draw it into my mouth where I suckle it.
I know I'm not the world's best homosexual, but even I know not to use words like suckle. Gays don't want to suckle anything. Our suckling days are over with. We're men. We guzzle dick. We hoover it. Swallow, gulp, but we do not suckle cock. That's disrespecting the penis. It deserves so much more than to just be suckled. I reject that on principle. This old fart doesn't know what the hell he's talking about. Let me fast forward to some dick play here.
My teeth, a little sharp, as they press into your flesh.
Sharp, toothy blowjobs. I'm starting to think this is some, like, conservative Christian operative. He's giving out all sorts of misinformation. Yeah, guys like it when you just suckle the tip of the dick. And also, use your teeth. Really chomp down on that motherfucker.
As my thumb and finger find your cockhead and gently
put a blowtorch to it. Like, no, that's not good either. Bad. Bad information.
Squeezing. Pulling the skin back and forth in that.
Dude, we know how to play with dicks. We've got our own. You don't have to go over this information. Is this some sort of remedial course for slow homosexuals? No, Ricky, don't use the foreskin like a glove. You don't want to put your whole hand in. No, you stroke it, Ricky. Can't believe we have to go over this again. Stroke the shaft skin up and down, up and down. All right, let me once again fast forward here.
Just pull out your legs for me. That's right. That's good.
Here we
go.
Good. Yes!
Feel my finger. Circle your ass. Feel my finger. Finding every nerve.
Yes, master.
Every ridge. And feel it as I push my mouth all the way down onto your cock. Feel my finger slide up into your ass.
But I poop from there.
Not right now, you don't. If you have a fetish of getting nailed by a serial killer, I could see the appeal of this tape. For the rest of you, though, find something else. Just watch porn.
You can feel my thick, long cock plunging, stretching, filling you. Your cock aching, throbbing. You know you're going to come any second. I'm going to thrust 3 times deep and hard into you.
This guy thinks very highly of himself. All it will take is 3 pumps, 3 thrusts into your butt, and you will achieve orgasm. I know you're all eager to move on, but I also know you want to know how this story ends, right?
On the 3rd, you come with me. Feel it now, little one. 3, oh, fuck yes. Ooh, 2, oh, yes. Oh, I'm going to come inside you. I'm going to fill you with my sperm, little one. You're going to come with me now.
This is a lot of pressure. You've got one thrust left, and you got to make 2 people come.
1, oh, come with me. Oh, ejaculate. Oh, feel it gush from both of us. Oh, fuck yes.
I learned that when you come, you're supposed to say, ejaculate, ejaculate. Your partner likes to hear that. It reminds me of those live-action role-playing guys when they're casting spells. Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt!
Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt!
Now that's how real studs come. You don't shout ejaculate over and over. You fuck her hard, fuck her fast, 3 thrusts, and as you're unloading in her, you scream, lightning bolt! Lightning bolt! I'm gonna try that. We're douche. Oh yeah, lightning bolt! Lightning bolt!
Oh, fuck yes. Oh yes. Oh yes. Feel my cock still filling you, but softening now.
It is quite astounding, isn't it? Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely. Not for very much longer. I'd say about 3 thrusts more. I remember suckling your wiener and fingering your anal ridges. When I hit the thrust of 3, we will both orgasm, and I'll shout, ejaculate! 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 There's gonna be tons of these, like, sexual instruction erotica audio pieces, but for, like, straight dudes, right? It's like a woman instructing a guy how to please her. We gotta find some of those. I guarantee you, in the straight version, the woman who's walking us through this all is not gonna be like 80 years old. Although, that would be great too. I will be on the lookout for that. Let's move on now. I've got a question for you. What is up with Muslims? I mean, seriously. Is that an okay thing to ask? I don't know. I feel like it is. Every other day on the podcast, I'm like, what the fuck's going on with these Christians? And then I play some whacked out Amish looking bitch in colonial streetwear saying rape isn't real and men control their pussies. I feel like it's okay to point out that other religions are also cuckoo crazy bananas. Haley's Comet shared a link to a TikTok channel called Marriages Halal. Word up. She's got a lot of great useful advice. For instance, if you catch your man cheating,
you need to forgive your husband for cheating, and you need to take accountability for your part that you played in this. And yes, you played a part in this. Take responsibility for what you did. Maybe you weren't having sex with him, and that's why he stepped out.
Maybe you laughed at him when he screamed, "Ejaculate! Ejaculate!" How do you think that made him feel? Of course he's gonna find another broad. Statistically speaking, women are 75% to blame whenever a man cheats. You can't argue that. It's math. I know it kind of sounds like she's really hard on women here, but she's got advice for guys as well.
As a man, you need to limit the time you hang out with your family because it's making you weak.
I know, guys, it's a tough pill to swallow. As much as you want to be with your wife and take care of the kids and do chores, the best thing you can do for your marriage is hang out with your buddies. Go to a bar. Chill out. Go to a game. Go on vacation with your friends. Stay as far away as humanly possible from the woman you married. After all, the best way to avoid divorce is to pretend you're not even married to begin with.
Hang out with other men. Number one, you'll find out that they'll motivate you. But number two, you'll also learn to stand your ground, be more confident, and be more manly and around masculine energy.
Yeah, that's one way it could go. Let me offer you a different scenario.
Feel my finger. Slide up into your ass.
Now that's what I call a weekend with the boys.
And you need that to be a strong, confident leader of your home.
I wish Islam was a little more friendly towards homosexuals, because I could see myself signing up for this. I like the way they think.
If your husband has multiple wives, can you have multiple husbands? No. I can only have one husband at a time. And that's just the Islamic law.
Just the way it goes. That's kind of what she says here. That's the way the cookie crumbles. I don't make the rules. I just follow them. Mainly so I don't get stoned in the town square.
So a woman can only have one husband at a time, but a husband can have up to a maximum of four wives at a time.
See, doesn't that sound good, guys? It gets better, though.
If you're worried that you bringing your husband other wives or other women to marry, that he'll leave you, he will never leave you. He will.
Yeah, there's a possibility that your wife's just gonna, like, bring over other chicks. How about this piece of fine wool? You don't even have to put any effort into finding women to fuck.
Love you and walk, like kiss the earth you walk on. He'll love every part of you because you understand him and you understand what he needs and what
Cunt.
He wants.
Yes.
And that's
Pussy.
Really what he wants at the end of the day. Men are very simple. They want to have sex, they want to eat good food, and they want to have a friend that they can share their emotions with. Just be that for them, and inshallah, you'll have a happy, healthy marriage.
Gotta be honest with you, it does sound a lot more fun than Christianity. Boring. I love this woman because it's always like the woman's fault and the guys are perfect. They just want sex. You should give them women to fuck.
If you're worried that your husband will marry another woman and leave you.
Let me guess. It's your fault.
Probably because you're not treating him right.
Told
you. If you were treating him right.
We wouldn't be in this position. See? You're the problem. You're always the problem. And don't you forget it. Well, maybe we should check in with the number one religion of choice here in the United States.
It's like a trampoline for your britch.
No, not Scientology. Good guess, though. No, I'm talking about Christianity, of course. We've got a clip here of an evangelist named Mike Dahl. For some reason, he is filming inside of a spa.
You still protest the former Virgin Mary. You still protest evil fallen.
I'm not sure if he's upset with this spa or if he's just condemning demons in general.
Religions. You still protest. I say that's not popular today. That's not trendy today. Today it's all about the fashion of this world. Oh, go to the spa. Go to the spa. Go to the salon. Have perfect hair. Go to the spa. Go to the spa.
Have perfect hair.
Well, like, this spa did nothing to you, dude.
Go to the spa.
They're ruining their business.
Have perfect hair. Oh, spend a day at the spa, but look, there's no spa in hell.
You don't know that. May not be a good spa, but...
See, you preach against the spa. You preach against trendy, fashionable hair. And the fashion of the world. And having all these fancy, expensive clothes. And yachts and cars. And that leads me to my fifth point.
Yeah, and maybe like going on expensive vacations and stuff, right?
Even
an evangelist deserves a vacation.
Yeah, he's on the Grand Cayman Islands in this video. Are you guys keeping up here? Spas are a disgusting display of wealth, vanity, and consumption, but a 14-day all-inclusive 5-star resort package on the Cayman Islands is a way to get back in touch with the healing power of Jesus, apparently. Get closer to God and enjoy cuisine by a 3-Michelin-star chef at the Ritz-Carlton. Hallelujah! Guys, this isn't a disgusting display of wealth. This is showing that Jesus provides. Here's another video where he's in New York City.
As I stand and I look at Manhattan.
I don't know if you can tell this by his quivering voice, but he's crying here.
This is last call for America. This is God's 2-minute warning. If you think you've seen something, you haven't seen anything yet.
What does he care? I mean, wouldn't it be better for him if God speeds up this whole wrath on America, tribulation, revelations, all that shit, right? Because then, you know, then he'll be up in heaven, reaping all the rewards and whatever heaven has to offer him. If we all do repent, if we all ask for forgiveness and God's like, all right, all is forgiven, then you're just going to be stuck on this earth a little bit longer before you can finally ascend and receive your, you know, otherworldly riches. I'm sorry, to me, it sounds more fun to be a Muslim. They ain't worrying about all this stuff. Muslims are off hanging out with their boys. Meanwhile, the wives are just looking for other women to get fucked by their husbands. I was out shopping for new wives for you, honey. Thanks. Let's move on. I've got a couple other real short clips here before we get into the news. This one was submitted in the Discord as well, so thank you so much for that. You know, I love live streamers when they freak out or their mom yells at them or something on stream. We've got a guy here who is being stream sniped. And that's where, like, you're watching someone play a game and then you start playing against that person and you can sort of see what he's doing because you're watching his stream. So you know where he's at. You know his position. You know what type of guns and ammo and fucking shit he has. Kind of giving you an unfair advantage. So in this clip, a streamer keeps getting killed and he claims that the person who's doing it is stream sniping him and he gets very, very angry. That cracking you heard is his controller. I don't know if he has like a stockpile of these things or if he just breaks them all the time. Yeah, he's storming around there. I feel like if you're going to be playing this game for a living, you can't have rage issues like this. You can't be breaking your equipment every time you lose a match.
All right, guys, if they join session again, I'm just going to have to fucking stop playing.
I don't want to play with those guys anymore. They're too good.
Until they leave. Like,
I mean, he might know something we don't. You know, these might be well-known stream snipers. Or, I don't know.
Until they leave. Like, all they're doing is hurting my livelihood.
The funniest thing is that this guy is like about 400 pounds, but in the corner, it's just like an exercise bike that, you know, hasn't been touched in years. Along with a can of WD-40.
Because at this point, they're going to follow me around when I stream, and they're affecting my business at this point.
Yeah.
Honestly, they're affecting my ability to make money.
I would argue you make more money being stream sniped because you lose your fucking shit, you break your controller, you throw stuff around, you stomp. That's what people want to see. Just make sure to monetize these clips, dude. You'll be golden.
It appear offline doesn't work. I'm fucking offline. No, they're joining through recent players.
Look here! Look, listen!
Now he's getting mad at other people in the chat. They're trying to be helpful!
No, they're joining through recent players.
God damn it!
Look here! Look, listen!
This is affecting my livelihood!
Appearing offline does not fucking stop it. So stop giving fucking advice you know nothing about.
Can't he just play with, like, random people? Or, you know, have the computer... I know nothing about these games, I apologize. I play my little baby Nintendo games and No Man's Sky. But I'm pretty sure, like, most games will just, like, randomly match you up, right?
I'm banning anybody trying to give me advice. Real talk.
What a way to foster a community. He's raging out, screaming at everyone who's trying to be helpful. He's going to die again here. Yep, well, there goes the controller. Hey! He got up out of his chair.
Fuck!
Well, now he's pounding the wall. We put a hole in the wall, or at least a dent.
All right, guys, I give up. I don't know when I'll stream again. I really need to make this fucking money. I really wanted to get this fucking surgery, man. I've wanted it so fucking bad.
Oh, no. he wants the weight loss surgery? Oh, poor guy.
I don't know when I'll stream again.
Oh.
I really need to make this fucking money. I really wanted to get this fucking surgery, man. I've wanted it so fucking bad.
Oh, no. Jesus.
I just can't do it. I can't take this shit no more, man.
Dog's freaking out in the background.
All I wanted to do was, like, I was fucking lonely. I wanted to just fucking stream and have a good time. Maybe have a good game.
I'm sorry.
I hate my life.
Oh, Jesus. Play a different game. Go offline. Play some Tetris for your viewers. What a badass playing Call of Duty. Blubbering.
Sorry.
You should feel flattered that people are watching your stream. They want to fuck around with you. Well, there you go. Just a streamer getting sniped. Finally, now, before we get into the news, I think this was another submission in the Discord, but I just quickly looked there and I couldn't find this video. So I'm so sorry, whoever posted this, I would like to give you credit. But we've featured Andy Rayfelt before. He makes interesting music. And here he is with a James David Manning. Ugh. You remember, he's a long-legged Mac Daddy preacher. Here he is in a metal remix. Doesn't sound very metal yet. It's nice.
God's gonna put a cancer in the butthole. God's gonna put a cancer in the butthole of every sodomite. Every sodomite butthole will get cancer in the butthole. It'll burn and burn and burn. They won't be able to sit down because of the burning in their butthole. You can't sit down because of the burning in their butthole. You can't sit down.
Yeah, that is a clip we know well here on DV. I love hearing it in being used in new and exciting ways. Metal remix. And he's a really good guitarist.
He's got a burning in his bottle. He's got a fire out of flame coming out of his bottle.
I will provide a link on the show notes today to this video if you want to check it out. I urge you all to. It's funny because I used this same Pastor Manning clip to make my own remix a while ago. You all remember this version.
And there'll be people walking around all over America with flames coming out of their buttholes. You ain't seen nothing yet. Butthole. If you thought that AIDS was bad, you ain't seen nothing yet. Flaming butthole. And you will not be able to sit down. Butthole. You ain't seen nothing yet.
I smell a Tim and Andy collaboration in the future. All right, and with that, let's get into the crazy bizarre twist to that fucked up news. Right up. It's that part of the show where I urge you all to become a member of the Sideshow and grab a weekly exclusive content. Yeah, typically on Tuesday and Thursday, we do Sideshow exclusive episodes. This week should be no different. Become a member of the club, one of my buddies. Go to superfreaksideshow.com. You can sign up through the website. All major credit cards and PayPal accepted. Only $6.99 a month, even less when you opt for a quarterly, semi-annual, yearly, or lifetime membership. If you sign up through the website, you can download episodes on the website, or you get access to a special little RSS feed that you can plug in and use with most podcasting apps, ones that accept username and passwords. If you happen to use Apple Podcasts or Spotify, you can sign up right in those apps. If you go that route, you'll just get the Sideshow exclusive episodes in those apps right alongside the feed. For more information on all the ways to sign up and the differences and all that, check out distortedview.com and superfreaksideshow.com. Again, thank you so much to everyone who has supported DV over the years, and more importantly, ones that continue to support DV. I would not be able to do the show without your support. It's funny, when I look at expenses, you know, just whatever expenses I have in life, I think of it in terms of how many Sideshow memberships it costs. I was looking at trying to lower my hosting bill, because right now I'm paying over $300 a month just to host distortedview.com and superfreaksideshow.com and the MP3 files and stuff. I need at least 50 subscribers just to cover that. I need another, 10 subscribers to cover my Adobe fees each month, you know, like Photoshop and Audition and stuff. Okay, that's great. Car payment. That's going to take another 60 subscribers, or, you know, whatever it is. So thank you to everyone who continues to support DV. I need each and every one of you. There are other ways to support the show. We've got a Patreon account, patreon.com/distortedview. You can pledge as little as a dollar over there. Every little bit helps. If you pledge at least $5, you get access to a special voicemail line where I will play your calls first. And I bet we've got some patrons checking in today. We'll get to that in just a few minutes. But first, we've got a couple news stories. We begin in Japan. What do you think, guys? Should we continue using this intro for Japanese stories? Or should we go with me singing anime?
Not again! All right, no, enough of this.
Enough of this. I'm a man. Manly. Yes, a waitress from a Japanese cafe in Hokkaido, Japan, was fired for mixing her own blood into the cocktails she served. Ew, wait, blood from where exactly? It's all gross, don't get me wrong. But in a weird way, don't you think that menstrual blood kind of pairs well with a Bloody Mary? It just kind of makes sense. Now, if we're talking a fruity drink, something with syrups or one of those berry margaritas, I'd totally expect just like normal blood from a fingertip or bloody nose or whatever. Bloody Mary, though, I just assume it's going to be cunt blood. Does that make sense to anyone? The Mondeji Cafe in Sapporo announced the news on Twitter, saying that they have fired the unidentified woman who made customers' drinks called Orikaku, or original cocktail, mixed with fruits, colorful syrups, and her own blood. Such an act is no different from part-time terrorism and is absolutely not acceptable, the cafe tweeted on April 2nd, adding that the business was shut down for a day to replace all of its drinking glasses. The owner also tweeted a separate statement to apologize to customers for the incident. Please let me continue the store. What? Please let me continue the store a little longer so I can be happy alone. Something was lost in the translation there, I think. I'll clean the store, change glasses, and dispose of alcohol that may have been contaminated. Once again, I'm very sorry to have caused you trouble at this time, the owner tweeted. By the way, the cafe's name loosely translates to Problem Child Concept Cafe. I guess they only hire bad girls. Well, this is what you get. Fucking hiring weirdos. It advertises itself as a space where dark girls and problem children, who are also the cutest, serve customers. Okay, so this is an establishment for like pervert guys with a fetish. I doubt most of them would even mind that a girl bled in their drinks. As a matter of fact, maybe one of them asked for the girl to do this. One of the specialties at this cafe is an all-you-can-drink menu. That certainly sounds like it could be a problem. I don't know what alcohol culture is like in Japan, but if that type of special was routinely available here in the United States, we'd all be dead. We would have all succumbed to alcohol poisoning or killed one another on our way home, you know, after visiting this place. Drunk driving. If you want to partake in the all-you-can-drink menu, it's only $19. They should rename this cafe from Problem Child Concept to Alcohol Enablers or Blackout Cafe. Right? That's what they're going for, right? All right. Japan, which is known for its concept cafes, has a variety of maid and butler cafes. Okay, not the same thing here. Many of which are located in Tokyo's famed Akihabara district. It's been a bad couple weeks for the food and beverage industry over there in Japan. We were just reading about sushi terrorism, which is a real thing. That's what they call it, sushi terrorism. Some food establishments like the conveyor belt sushi chain Shoshiro have faced issues with a trend called sushi terrorism. There was a spat of incidents where people would film viral videos of themselves contaminating a communal soy sauce bottle. Like they would lick it and stuff and lick the sushi meant for other customers. And then, you know, put the sushi back on the conveyor belt. Oh, I hate using things on restaurants that are communal. Soy sauce bottles, ketchup bottles, hate all that. The pandemic did a good job eliminating that bullshit, but you'll still find it now. I suggest you all just either eat at home or bring your own condiments to the restaurant. You never know what people are licking or slobbering all over. Jesus Christ. Speaking of disgusting, second story we have for you today. Water filter guru. No, that's not the alias of a distorted view caller. We got Twink Toilet and Water Filter Guru. Water Filter Guru is a company. I guess they have something to do with water filtering. They surveyed over 1,000 people to shed light on personal hygiene habits, and the results, as always, are disgusting. I mean, I wouldn't bother sharing the results with you unless they were disgusting, right? You know, when it comes to the bathroom, there are all sorts of bad habits you can have, not washing your hand after you piss or shit. I gotta be honest with you, sometimes after I pee, I don't wash my hands. My dick is perfectly clean. It's not going anywhere. It's just been tucked away, pressed up against some cotton fabric. Not like I piss all over my hands or anything. You know, it's clean. It's touching skin. I mean, if I'm out and about, like if I use a public, you know, if I'm out at a restaurant and I have to piss or something, of course, I'm going to wash my hands. But if I'm at home, you know, if I'm recording the show or something and I have to run, take a pee, I'm not going to wash my hands. Come on. Same with taking a shit. Unless my finger breaks through that toilet paper and brushes up against my hole. No, I'm kidding. You'll always wash your hands after you take a shit. You don't know what the hell is going on back there. You can't see. You may think things are fine, that either there's no accidental touching or brushing up against. But guys, come on. We live in a society. Don't be gross. Well, what exactly did water filter guru find? Well, it turns out that nearly a quarter of people wash their genitals in the sink. That's called a whore's bath, right? 3 in 10 people, that's 30% of people, pee in the shower. Guys, I don't make it a habit of pissing in the shower, but I may have done that a few times. I wonder how the question was worded, because it's like, have you ever peed in the shower? Only 3 in 10 people, I call bullshit on that. If it's like, do you regularly piss in the shower? That's, you know, that's a little stranger. All right. It's not all bad news, though. The average American showers 6 times a week for about 15 minutes each time. That's about right. 15 minutes. I think that's how long I'm in there. Do the math. And that is 4,600 minutes and nearly 10,000 gallons of water a year per person. I can't wrap my mind around that. Those numbers are just too huge. Each person uses 10,000 gallons of water a year. And for the most part, like, you know, we've been doing this for years, decades, hundreds of years, whatever. Like, it's sustainable. There's that much fucking water on the planet. Like, fresh water. We're not even talking about the oceans. It's crazy. Gen Zers were the only age group who showered less, just 5 times a week. Y'all stink. Time spent in the shower also varied by generations. Millennials took the longest showers. I guess I'm considered a millennial. I straddle the Gen X / millennial generations. I belong in a group, either like on Facebook or Reddit or something, called Zennials, which is for that very tiny group of people like who were born like 1979, 80, 81. That's neither here nor there, I guess. Millennials took the longest showers and Gen Zers took the shortest. Unsurprisingly, Gen Z was also most likely to say that the environmental impact affected their shower length. Using less water reduces CO2 emissions. Also, it uses less water. So shorter showers can significantly help the health of the environment. How come older people weren't surveyed, like Gen Xers or boomers? I want to know their shower habits. Oh, they do mention baby boomers here. Baby boomers and millennials in particular shared the feeling that partnered showers led to less fighting. I can't get Lord Douche to shower with me. The only time he ever suggests it is when he wants to pee on me to establish dominance, and I am not down for that. Also kind of strange, more than half used something other than shampoo to wash their hair. Nearly everything in the kitchen from egg yolks to baking soda. What the fuck are you people doing in there? You're inviting your partner in there, cooking fucking breakfast, eating eggs. The shower seems to be a place for people to multitask, as 37% of men confess to video chatting while having a shower. Women, on the other hand, were more likely to brush their teeth or pee in the shower. Women are the ones to piss in the shower. All right, now here's the real shocking stat for you. 12%. That's over 10. It is a substantial number, in my opinion. 12% of people admitted to pooping in the shower. There is a big difference between pissing in the shower and pooping. I mean, is this an emergency situation or is this just like you feel the need to go? And if so, a standard BM is not liquid. So you're going to have to like curb stomp the turd down the drain, you know, because it's not just a hole. It's like a grate. If any of you freaks partake in shitting in the shower, please call into the voicemail line and explain your position. And by that, I want to know exactly what position you're in when you're taking a shit in the shower. Like, do you hover over the grate? Are you just like completely standing up? Are you crouching? Are you on all fours? Are you in the missionary position? Like, what the fuck is going on in there? I went to waterfilterguru.com to look up some other interesting stats from this survey. Nothing beats the poop thing, by the way. We're not going to top that. To prolong your time between showers, the number one way to keep genital stink away, apparently, is washing your genitals at this sink, at the stink. 26% of respondents do that. 23% use wet wipes on their genitals, while only 21% go the deodorant method. They roll on antiperspirant Old Spice in their crotch or something. Okay. 30% of respondents peed in the shower. 29% cried. 27% masturbated. 25% blew their nose into their hands. Just snot rocketing that stuff into your palms. Nice. Okay, well, for more stats and percentages, check out waterfilterguru.com. And finally today, freaks, we just happen to have one here from our most fucked up state. Say it with me.
Florida is the most fucked up state.
A Florida man charged with indecent exposure offered cops a bizarre explanation as to why he was pleasuring himself in public. I actually had to double check and make sure we hadn't covered this story already because it sounds so familiar. And then I remembered, oh, it's Florida, Florida man. Half the stories about Florida man are about public masturbation. I'm going to go with no, we haven't read this one, because when we get to the explanation, it is a new twist I hadn't heard before, I think. Officers were dispatched Sunday morning to a Speedway convenience store in Vero Beach after a 911 caller, quote, advised there was a naked white male screaming at a white female on the side of the road. Upon arriving at the scene, officers encountered Jason Roach. That name sounds familiar. And now I'm starting to think that we did read this story. Jason Roach, with whom they were already familiar. Maybe that's why. Maybe he appeared in a previous news story. I don't know. The 40-year-old Roach, cops reported, had been questioned twice the prior evening in connection with alleged masturbation incidents at an Arby's restaurant and a Wawa convenience store. You know, he's a serial masturbator. In both instances, Roach stopped and went on his way. I feel like this is all the cops' fault, honestly. If you get a call about someone masturbating in public, don't just tell them to be on their way. Just, hey, I don't want to see you again. More importantly, I don't want to see that again, if you know what I mean. And then he goes around and does it again. First at an Arby's, second time masturbating at a Wawa. The second time, the police should have totally arrested him. In both instances, Roach stopped and went on his way. Maybe, and hear me out here, maybe the cops, the second time, instead of arresting him, should have said, all right, look, go into the Wawa stall, the restroom. We'll guard the door so no one comes in. Just masturbate. Get it out of your system. Once he blows his load, he probably won't do it again for a while. He just needs to nut. Get a little post-orgasm clarity. sleep it off, you know, but, you know, they didn't do that either. So it happened a third time. A witness told police that Roach was naked and touching himself in the motion of masturbating while near the speedway at around 6 a.m. When questioned about his activities, Roach reportedly said that he was having issues with his rectum. Do I even need to play the sound clip? So, yeah, you know, his rectum was irritated, and so he thought the best way to get rid of the pain was to ejaculate. That's what he said. He said in order to get rid of the pain, he has to ejaculate. Apparently, this has happened before. It's just a thing. It's a medical condition. You can't arrest someone for a medical condition. Despite the explanation, Roach was arrested for exposure of sexual organs, a misdemeanor. He was booked into the Indian River County Jail, Native American County Jail. It's 2023. Geography is so insensitive. All right. He's being held on a $50,000 bond. Roach, who is scheduled for a May 2nd arraignment, has previously been convicted of battery, ting, petty theft, ting, ting, violating a protective order, ting, 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 burglary, ting, 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 grand theft, filing a false document, and resisting police. This is his first time for, like, public lewdness. Or whatever, this exposure of sexual organs. So this is a new one for him. It's exciting. I like this guy because he's never arrested for the same thing twice. If you look at his rap sheet, it's like he's trying to just collect them all. And he doesn't want any repeats. Battery, theft, protective order, burglary, grand theft, filing false documents, resisting police, exposing sex organs. What's next for you, Mr. Roach? Well, I don't want to get my hopes up, but I've had my eye on a vehicular manslaughter charge. We'll see how the year goes. All right, there you go. That, my friends, is your distorted news from Monday. Let's do a couple voicemails and get the hell out.
Why did man have to have such a sweet rectum?
I'm sorry. I had to do it. It was going to bug me. Cannot talk about rectums without playing that clip. All right, guys, love to hear from you freaks, and there are many ways to contact the show. show@distortedview.com. I'm all over social media at DistortedView on Twitter and Instagram, facebook.com/DistortedViewShow. Remember, if you pledge $5 to our Patreon account, you get access to a special voicemail line. And yes, we have got some freaks calling in.
Hey, Kenny Boo, this is Lars in California.
Hey, Lars.
On today or yesterday's show or today's show or whatever it is, the Seven Tentacles show, you were talking about Little Dicky and his two holes. And
yes, he suffers from that hypospadia thing where, like, his dick hole is not at the right spot, right? It's kind of on the top or bottom.
He's busy pee out of both holes.
And he has
one hole,
multiple holes.
Pee out of the other hole. And as somebody with a Prince Albert piercing, I'll let you know.
Yeah, but that's different, though. That doesn't go through your urethra, right?
I'll let you know that if I don't have a piercing in, or if I'm wearing a small gauge piercing, yes, the pee, you piss out of both holes.
Really?
It sucks if you're standing at a urinal because you're.
Oh, I guess Prince Albert does. It is in your cock hole. That's what. Yeah. Okay. You're right.
Your pants,
I'm sorry.
Pissing into the urinal, so you don't do a lot of that. But,
wow.
Yes, and with no piercing in, if you plug the main hole, if you cover the main hole with your finger, it all comes out the piercing hole, vice versa. So that answers your question there.
That seems like a lot of, that seems like a huge con of getting one of those things. Now, I don't know if you're circumcised or uncircumcised, but I'd imagine that it's even worse for uncircumcised men because, I don't know, like, it just, like, the pee could get trapped in there, and then I just feel like you could get some sort of infection or rash or something. Oh, it just seems like a lot of trouble. I mean, is it worth it? Is the Prince Albert worth it, really? I mean, what's the appeal? Does it feel really
Jamie
good?
Boo. Sweet toilet again. I know. I'm getting back into old habits, calling you multiple times.
That's okay.
But I'm mad at you because I hurt myself at the gym I made the fatal mistake of listening.
That's a big mistake, listening to Distorted View Daily. You can just stop right there.
To Distorted View while working out, which is a terrible idea because it breaks your concentration. And Galileo kept saying, wet, dry world. And he kept, like, feverishly repeating it. And
yeah,
it,
wet, dry world.
And couldn't stop laughing.
Yeah.
I dropped a dumbbell on my foot.
Oh, my God. Well,
that man.
Send me your medical bills.
She's from wet, dry world.
Yeah.
We'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Actually, send your medical bills to Galileo. Freak.
Kelly's comment. Oh. We may not be sunk on the conservative beer just yet.
I found
Haley's comment wants to keep this one alive.
Yet. I found out that there may be some legal challenges from Anheuser-Busch because the beer is ultra-conservative, and Anheuser-Busch owns Michelob Ultra. So,
oh, is like you can't use Ultra at all when it comes to beers?
We'll see what happens, but they may get taken down by a lawsuit before they can even brew the beer.
Yes!
We're not done yet.
The problem is, I think we're still too late. Again, Joe Rogan got on his podcast, and a lot of like conservative people listen to him, and he's like, oh, this, you know, Budweiser ban is stupid. And then even like, I think Donald Trump Jr. tweeted that we shouldn't be protesting Bud Light because Anheuser-Busch donates to Republicans more than they donate to Democrats. And obviously they want that money to keep rolling in. And if conservatives, you know, boycott, then maybe they'll, you know, they won't donate as much. You know, so I just feel like this whole thing is falling apart. We'll see how it goes, though. I still haven't reached out to Mead about being the spokesperson. Although Mead recently posted a new song for patrons. I think Mead is very worried that like DoorDash delivery people are like spitting in his food and stuff because he wrote a song about it. That is his newest opus. Here's a little bit from Please Don't Spit in My Food.
I got my food up ready, think I'll order some spaghetti, maybe a little chocolate cake for dessert.
Okay, it's already not one of his best songs. He's trying to fit in a lot of big words there.
But the last time I ordered, I found something fishy. It wasn't on the menu. I became alert. Oh, I'm gonna be brave and order something to eat again. I just hope it will be okay. I'm putting my life in your hands, so make sure you wash them. And before you stop by, I just gotta say, please don't spit in my food, Mr. Delivery Driver. Please don't spit in my food. I know you're overworked, I know you're underpaid, but that's no reason to be rude.
Oh boy. I like the fact that Mead is moving on from whatever the hell type of music he normally does to like these novelty songs, but he's not exactly a comedian, you know? All right, well, there you go. That is all the time we have on this edition of the program. I want you guys to email me, show at distortedview.com. DistortedView.com is our official website. Voicemail line for you, 206-666-4463. That's 206-660. Oh, God, is it? Oh, God.
It's like a trampoline for your britch.
Spread the distortion, STD. Tell all your friends about the show. Don't forget to give us a 5-star rating, a thumbs up, or like wherever you can rate and review podcasts. Tomorrow's episode is going to be sideshow exclusive. If you want to hear it, you got to sign up. Otherwise, I'll see you back on Wednesday. Until then, have a great day. Bye, everybody.
It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely. Not for very much longer. I've got to keep control.
Ah! Sorry. I remember
doing the time warp, drinking those moments when the blackness would hit me and the void would be calling. Let's do the time warp.
Oh, fuck it. So stupid. Okay, done.
This has been another excellent podcast from the Scribe Media Group. Learn more at scribe.net.